Welcome everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week we're going to do the sketch or pencil line effect in Affinity Photo, and I'm going to show you five different looks we can achieve using this effect. So we're going to add our sketch effect. I'm going to show you how to add some color to that sketch effect. I'm going to show you how to add like a blue or any color outline on that sketch effect that you would like to do. We've also got a multiple or rainbow effect that we can achieve, and we're also going to add a textured background to our pencil or sketch effect. As usual, let's get started. Let's get rid of what we've got here so far and start from scratch. This is the photo we're going to use, and the first thing we're going to do is on the background layer is duplicate the layer with a command J. Okay, once we've got our layer duplicated, we're going to come down here to our adjustments, and we're going to add a black and white adjustment. Let's clip this black and white adjustment to our background layer here, and on this layer with the black and white adjustment, we're going to come up here to layers, and we're going to go merge visible. On our merge visible layer, we're going to invert that layer, and we're going to use a command I to invert it. We're going to change the blend mode to color dodge. Now on this layer here, the inverted layer with the blend mode of color dodge, we're going to add a live filter, and we're going to add a Gaussian blur. On our Gaussian blur here, we're going to start turning up the radius to the right until we see our pencil effect coming in. We can now manipulate the look of our pencil look. We can go all the way up to the top and get a really detailed look, or we can come back all the way down the bottom for that really thin line pencil sketch look. I'm going to take mine up to about 40 for that sort of more detailed look at the moment. We can come back and manipulate that a little bit further later. So let's click off that. That's our pencil sketch look. Now let's add some color to our pencil sketch here. So on our original background here, let's go Command J and let's drag that layer all the way up the top. Now if we come to our blend mode and change our blend mode to color, you can see now that it's added some color to our sketch lines. And we can manipulate that with our opacity up here for a lighter or stronger look. We can take it down for a lighter look, or we can bring it back up. I'm going to leave mine about 75. Okay, let's have a look at another look now. Let's click off this layer here and let's grab our rectangle tool here. I've got my color set to blue already, so let's just drag that over the top. You can change this color to anything you like. You can change it to green, blue, purple. I'm going to go for that more of a biro look, and I'm just going to click in here to get that sort of blue biro look or pen look, and I'm going to change the blend mode of the rectangle up here to color, and that will put some color into our pencil lines, more like that this photo has been drawn with a pen or a biro. Again, we can manipulate how strong that is with our opacity up the top here, and again I'll leave mine at 75. Okay, let's click off that one again and let's grab another rectangle tool. It's going to go blue again because I've got blue selected. That's okay. Let's come over here now and grab our gradient tool and let's draw a gradient all the way down across here. You can go any direction you want, up or down, any direction. Let's add a couple of more points along our gradient here. That should do it. And then on each of these points here, let's change the color. Let's start with red. You can choose any colors that you want. Let's just work our way down here, adding some extra colors. Lucky last down here, let's go for a purple, and we can click off that now. And again, we just need to change the blend mode to color, and that's given us our sort of rainbow or all sorts of different colors. Again, we can use our opacity to either make that stronger or lighter. Click off that one again now, and on top of this layer here, we can add a levels adjustment right on top. And with our sketch effect here, we can start taking this up and we can go all the way for this really charcoal look if we want to. I might leave this about 30 for a little bit more detail. You can also use your Gaussian blur adjustment down here to adjust that as well. More detail, less detail. There we go, everybody. We've created five different looks. We can do that really dark charcoal look using our levels adjustment. We can have the colored look using our background that we duplicated and brought up the top and changed the blend mode. We've also got our pen or biro look here. And we've also got our rainbow or multi-color effect on the top here as well. There's one last thing I'm going to do for this photo, and that is add a really nice textured background. And on this one, we'll just do Command-C. Come over here to our sketch effect and Command-V. Just grabbing my move tool here, going to add this effect all the way over the photo here. Really nice texture, and I'll link this below. It's from Unsplash. Let's bring that all the way to the top if it's not already on the top, a very top layer, and let's change the blend mode of that to multiply. And that will bring our sketch or text effect through onto that really nice textured paper. We can turn our colors on. We can have our blue. We can have our colored effect there as well. I'm going to leave mine with the sketch effect. So I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial this week. 5 different looks we can achieve with the sketch or pencil effect in Affinity Photo. If you have enjoyed the tutorial, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. Until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.